Meet Lacey and Pedro, the newest trainees for Davidson Athletics primary care sports physician, Dr. Robert Lutz, and his wife Susie's organization, Continuing the Mission.
So Continuing the Mission serves to fulfill an unmet need for veterans with post-traumatic stress disorder. We fill that role by acquiring, training, pairing, and then for the life of the dog, providing sustaining support to veterans to help them reintegrate in society and to, as an aid in their treatment. It's not gonna completely cure their issues, but it can serve as an adjunct in treatment and reintegration back in society.
Dr. Lutz and Susie started the organization in 2016 and often use the bustling Davidson campus to help the puppies in training socialize and show them how to react in busy settings.
Well, we bring the puppies on campus for socialization. The students love them, and our secondary mission is to touch as many lives with the leash as we can. So we enjoy seeing college kids light up, and they tell us all kinds of things like, oh, this is perfect. My boyfriend broke up with me today. I needed this. And oh, I miss my dog. We see pictures of all their dogs at home, and we just feel like we're socializing our puppies, and we're also doing something for the students here on campus, and it's a great blend.
Dr. Lutz joined Davidson after a lengthy military career, so this organization has an extra special meaning for him. In fact, Pedro was named by his sponsor to honor the crew of Pedro 66, the call sign of a U.S. Air Force HH-60 Pave Hawk helicopter that was shot down in Afghanistan in 2010 while on a mission to save a wounded Marine. The crash killed 5 of the 7 crew members.
So the very first patient we placed a dog with was actually one of my patients from my active duty time who I recognized was suffering with post-traumatic stress disorder. And it has changed his life immeasurably. He couldn't get out of the house, lots of anxiety issues, had trouble traveling, severely impacted his relationship with his wife and with his family. And he has done things. He's gone out to dinner, he's gone to movies, he's gone to the kids' recreational events. It's helped with his nightmares. And just to see that transformation over the last 3 years.
3 years. He's at the three-year mark now. And he's a different person.
Yeah.
He's a different person than the day I put that leash in his hand. And one of the things that is important to us is not that just we provide dogs to veterans, but we provide them a community, a support system, ongoing training. Courtney heads that up, and they recertify. There are tests they have to pass. They recertify with their dogs. But what we're seeing is this particular veteran is coming to Continuing the Mission fundraising events with his dog and being supportive of, you know, us growing as an organization. And he wouldn't have been able to do that prior to receiving his dog.
Service dogs are provided to veterans that sustained a significant injury or loss of limb during deployment, but not for vets that suffer from PTSD or other psychological struggles post-deployment. So Continuing the Mission helps fill the void.
One of our veterans relayed the story of like sitting at his desk, not realizing that he was getting extremely anxious, and then the dog just putting that big old lab head in his lap and breaking the behavior before it, like Susie said, before it got to the point where it interfered with his ability to continue to work. And that's when the magic happens, when the dogs anticipate and provide that support.
Taking about 2 years to train, Continuing the Mission has placed 6 dogs to date, with 3 more scheduled to be placed with their veterans in 2020. Pups that don't make the grade as service dogs get adopted and become wonderful family pets.
We have a birth to placement model. Primarily, we receive puppies around 8 weeks of age, and we won't place them until they're 2. And so they'll be with a puppy raiser until 14 to 16 months, and we work with the pups weekly and the puppy raiser. And then they'll come in for advanced training with Courtney when they're 14 to 16 months, and then we'll pair them with a veteran around age 2.
After building tight bonds, it's not always easy to let them go, but they understand the reward is unmeasurable.
You can imagine, so my son and his fiance raised one of the dogs in the program. And needless to say, he's very special to us, this dog. He ended up staying with us for about 6 months for his finishing training, just an awesome companion. And it was so hard to give him up. That being said, we have seen the change in the life that he's made of his veteran, and we realize that how selfish we would be if we kept this dog. And while it broke our heart, the dividends far surpass the pain of seeing him go.
The Davidson College community will continue to play an important role in the Leashes Touching Lives initiative.
You know, allowing us to come on campus, to bring dogs. Great as it is for the students to see a dog, it's great for the dogs to get the kind of exposure that they're getting, and really furthers their training down the line. And that's been a huge boon for us.